Okay, today I am doing some errands. I'll ramble a little bit shortly, but first off, I need to visit my father's house, who lives a little bit away from me, just around the corner. I'm nearly there now. So I can water his tomatoes. Then I shall be going off into the city to do a bit of shopping, a bit of browsing, a bit of espionage. No, it's not very much at all. But hopefully I will talk a little bit more on the way, and I'll fill you in on some of the details about what I'm going to be doing and why it's changed. And long-term plan, that kind of crap. So, stay tuned. Whoa, that was fun. Oh Christ, open some windows. It is warm in here. Turn that noise off. Thank you very much. Okay, so tomatoes are watered. On with the rest of the day. So I am heading into the city of Chester. I'm gonna do some shopping, some browsing, run some errands, that kind of deal. Nothing too exciting. I'm hoping that this video camera mount is now working. So I've been saying before, but in the past my videos have been very unedited, very crude, very wobbly, very low quality. This is gonna change that a little bit. I've got a proper mount now. Hopefully it isn't wobbly. I've not even checked yet, but fingers crossed that it's pretty sturdy. Looks okay. Looking at it at the moment, it looks okay. I'm not gonna look too much at it though, because I'm driving a vehicle at the same time. But you know, it is what it is. So I'm going to head to Chester. I'm going to charge my car because there's a charge point in Chester, and then I've got a long walk from the location of the charge point over to, don't hit that kid on his little bicycle. There's a very small kid on the main road. That is not safe. Oh, Jesus. It's like a fucking 4-year-old on a tiny little BMX just riding down the road. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna head to Chester. I'm gonna charge my car, assuming that the system's working, because there are certain networks of charging points that I like and some that I do not, and I'm going to one that I'm not a big fan of. Oh, we could indicate your penis. Phew, that was an awful roundabout. So, yeah, the charge point I'm going to is not one that I enjoy using, but it's like £1.20 for a full charge, and it's in Chester, so it works perfectly for me. I've gone, as you saw before, about 60%, I've got 50-ish miles or so, so I will, it'll work out nicely, it'll work out well. Anyway, I'll resume my whatever. And we are here, so now we have to hope that there's a point available. There should be one for either. I think there's 4 points here, so... Oh, and they're all completely open, but one has a big white sticker on it that looks out of order. Ooh, okay. Let's hope it's one of these ones then. Okay, that's out of service. Yeah, fine. So we're gonna, fingers crossed, that this one's not out of service also, and that it was not just falling off. I guess we'll find out very shortly.
Get the fuck in, there we go.
Smashing. So now I gotta decide, do I bother taking a coat? I brought a coat with me, but it's really, really hot right now. I'm gonna chance it. Screw it, leave the coat here. Hope it doesn't rain. It's definitely gonna rain.
So we've got a bit of a walk now. That's the price you pay for having free fuel in your car, and of course free parking as well. It's just a, you don't get free parking here. But I am gonna have to walk a significant distance to get to where I want to go today, because this is quite far out of the way. This is like a sort of, there's a lot of sort of big supermarket kind of things here too. This is such a weird part of Chester. It's like the outskirts of the main city. It's still very much Chester, but very much like the outside part of it. All we get is like car garages and supermarkets and big roads, and then you see like office shops and like supplies and things. It's like it's a really rough part, but not rough like dangerous, just rough like industrial. Nothing's particularly visually appealing. Everything's really kind of, it works. All the grey corrugated buildings, just nothing's nice looking. Everything's just so grey and functional, I guess. But luckily the wind's picking up a little bit now. Annoying for you, I'm sure this is very hard to hear anything. But at least it's not so hot anymore because my car is hot. I'm also super hungry. So I hope it doesn't rain. Hope I can get some food. And we'll get some scram. Nothing like running through lights, eh? Alright, we're getting a lot more Chester-y now. Looks very similar behind me, quite residential, lots of little apartments and buildings to rent. But we are approaching up onto the race course where the Chester race is, as you saw on that sign earlier. Obviously, at Hell. And just around this corner up ahead, I shall be entering the main part of Chester where it gets a lot more shops, a lot more vintage, less sort of new construction buildings and more. Older ones that have been around for a while, like Tudor times or something, I don't know.
Five P, my friend. Thanks,
everybody.
Thank you. Lloyd's moving 10, my friend.
Perfect,
okay.
I'll be over the side
there.
Cheers. With a different lady. Very nice choice today, sir. Glad you could join us. Come and get a good spot.
We're talking about Jesus. Come on. Hello, everyone. Hello. Keep walking. Nothing to see here. Hello. Lady, watch out. There's a suspicious man following you. I've seen him around before. All right, you're going to love this. Everyone, come on. Stop clapping. It's getting weird.
It is so busy today. Like, oh my god, how busy can it be? Can you see me?
I can see me.
Good. So, it turns out today is a bit of an odd day to come to Tesco. It has been ridiculously busy everywhere. It's been so busy. And the reason for that would be right behind me, right there. I don't know if that's mirrored for you, it's mirrored for me right now, but it's actually Ladies' Day, which sounds weirder than it is. It's the races that you saw on the traffic thing really earlier on. It's actually it's so busy. So everybody like gets really dressed up, like super smart. Like everybody was either wearing a full-on suit or like really nice dress and like, jewelry and like just really. Can you see me? It's too dark. It's like whatever. Yeah, really, really nice clothes. Like everyone's so smartly dressed. Everyone's sipping on like gin and tonics and things. And then they go for the races. And I guess Ladies' Day means it's, I guess, cheaper for women? I don't know. But it was today. And oh my god, it was so busy. I wanted to film one more in the city, but I couldn't do that. I haven't got the confidence to talk or vlog in public.
Yes.
Like I'm still trying to get that bit better, but it's taking me ages. Like I'm really nervous doing this in the street right now. There's cars right past that way. So that's why there's cuts there, and cut in with people. But, oh god, it was so busy. But on the other hand, it meant that I made the absolute right decision in parking where I did. Because not only did they charge for free, but it meant that I actually got to park. Not that I left for free, but I actually got to fall. Because my god, it was so busy. There'd be nowhere to park then.
I love that font. That is a nice font. That is my kind of font right there.
So I was heading back to the car, but I've just seen a store that I thought I was going to pop into. A little detour, and it is the Currys PC World Mega Store. I don't know what makes it a mega store. I'm going very much the back alley road here. Look at this, I'm right. Service access here, but it looks huge. I've never been there before, but it's a car phone warehouse as well. God, I don't know what this place is, but it looks like a huge and overpriced computer shop. So let's have a look, shall we? Defies physics. Well, that was kind of a cool place actually. It was absolutely huge, like I expected. It was massive. A lot of space between pieces of, so not as much stuff as I thought there'd be, a lot of room between the different displays, but a very big building, lots of cool stuff. It was, looking at the gaming PCs, obviously, why wouldn't I? As I was eyeing up some £1,000 PC, which I think was overpriced, I don't think it was anywhere near worth that much, but I was looking at it anyway, and this woman was about to sort of offer assistance to purchasing stuff, so they can help. She comes over to me and sees that I'm holding this camera on a tripod, got headphones in, and I'm wearing a PlayStation branded t-shirt, and she looks at me up and down and goes, "You don't need any help, do you?" I'm like, "Nah, I'm fine, thanks." that was quite fun. But yeah, that's a cool place. I'm with the car now though. I'm only a little bit away from the car, like 5 minutes tops. I can almost see him here actually. I'm just going to spend the back of a Frankie and Benny's because it's somewhere quiet to talk a bit. But yeah, head back to the car, unplug the charger, hopefully we're fully charged by now. We should be, that's where we wouldn't be. And I'll talk more in the car on the way home.
What happened here? Well, I have no idea what's happened to my car then. I completely thought I'd get here, I'd open the door and it would be full. But it's not. It's like 64% done and I have no idea why. It looked like it wasn't charging. Like I got here and it wasn't charging. I opened the door, I give it a second and it's just carried on charging now and I don't know what's happened. That's very unusual. Let me check the app to see what it reckons happened. And the app just crashed. Fantastic. It says I'm still charging. It says I've started charging at 12:35 and I'm 2 hours and 22 minutes into it. Again, that's reversed, so you can't see that. So that's really freaking weird. See, remember I was saying at the beginning of this video that I didn't trust these charge points, that I don't like them? Okay, well I'm gonna go walk around the supermarket for a little bit, got some time. Get a little bit more blast of power. Listen to some more music. I've had Zebrahead playing all damn day, so maybe I'll carry on a little bit more. And I'll hope that this carries on charging whilst I'm in there, because if it just stops and I walk away again, then I don't know what that's going to happen. But whatever, I might even actually start the air conditioning on a little bit too and let it cool down a little. Where's my fob? If I just click that button, anything working with me? Please? There we go. Okay. Look how sweaty the key fob is. That's how warm it's been in my pocket. It is so hot today. Well, car's still charging, 68% now. It's like I'm not going to wait for it to finish, but I will let it go a little bit longer while I talk to you guys for a bit. So I came looking for something very particular in mind, and I couldn't find it. I'm still looking. I can't reveal what it is because it's a secret, whatever you want to call it. But I'm looking for something quite particular. And I looked at a lot of similar things, and I spent about an hour in one store, and the sales clerk, the lady working there, brought me loads of different kinds of them. She brought all sorts of different options, lots of different varieties. She tried her hardest to get me to buy one of them, and I was like, I'm not completely convinced about them, and I haven't bought anything yet. So I will keep trying that. That poor woman, she was really helpful though. Shout out to you if you're watching. But yeah, I haven't found it yet. So, still looking. I've got a bit of time yet though, so that's okay. Picked myself up a new air freshener, smells like cherries, a bit of Bakewell-y. And okay, don't fizz. But, hope you've enjoyed this new style of vlog. Hope I do a lot more of them in the future. I'd love to. Hopefully I can edit this fine. I don't know how well my computer will edit it yet. Whenever I do get new parts to my PC, I will make a new PC that can edit these properly. But until then, I'll do what I can. Hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all later.